Mr. President, our people are our greatest asset. There is no investment more beneficial than investment in good health of people. Investment in health is investment in poverty alleviation, in generating jobs, in enhancing productivity, and in ensuring inclusive economic growth and healthier, safer, and fairer societies. We thank France for putting forward a resolution this year on behalf of the 7 member countries on promoting an inclusive approach to strengthening health systems. We would like to highlight the following points in this context. Affordability is the key to equitable access to healthcare. Stronger health systems must guarantee both access and choice. The full use of TRIPS flexibilities, including the development and use of generics and local manufacturing capacities to meet public health objectives. Transparency in cost and price of medicines and other technologies, innovative partnerships in R&D, and the full use of new and emerging technologies and appropriate use of traditional medicines are critical in this context. Both public and the private sector have a role to play in building stronger health systems. However, we need to be cautious about commercialization of health services. A strong public health system is needed to act as a guarantor. We need to address shortages by aligning training, recruitment, distribution, and retention of the health workforce to serve in the areas where the need is the greatest. Community health workers play a crucial role in covering the last mile in the delivery of services. We need to strengthen their capacity. Clinical research and innovation is of utmost importance for healthcare system strengthening. As we experience rapid global spread of digital health technologies, we need to assess their design and delivery and ensure that these applications bring desired health outcomes. Mr. President, the healthcare reform that is taking place currently in India at an unprecedented scale and scope. Our holistic approach to healthcare with public-private partnership provides a unique model for the developing world. India has launched the National Health Protection Scheme in September 2018. The scheme is based on the twin pillars of expanding access to primary healthcare services through health and wellness centers and providing insurance coverage for secondary and tertiary care hospitalization for poor and vulnerable families. We saw the transformative potential of affordability when Indian pharmaceutical companies supplied medicines to HIV and AIDS patients in Africa for less than a dollar a day in the early years of this millennium. Today, a large proportion of the antiretroviral drugs used globally to combat HIV and AIDS are supplied by Indian pharmaceutical firms. India is not only the largest provider of generic drugs globally, but also caters to over 60% of the global demand for various vaccines. We have also been partnering with African countries by developing telemedicine facilities. Mr. President, in India, it is a general belief that the health and wellness depend on a delicate balance between the mind, body, and spirit. The world has come to recognize the value of this holistic approach. We are not just fighting diseases, we are promoting good health. If the issue of inclusivity is at the core of the health agenda, our efforts to improve global health cannot be achieved by ignoring traditional and holistic health systems.